What inspired you to get together and play music, John?
Basically, the people, likes of Buddy Holly, Eddie Cochran, Elvis, Lonnie Donegan, Hank Williams, all these people who played guitars and sang and rock and roll, inspired all those lads on the Dole in Liverpool at the time to form bands, skiffle groups, as you call them in them days, with your tea chests and your acoustic guitars and street corners. I mean, there were so many bands about Liverpool that are bound to happen. So, I mean, lots of kids get together, lots of kids go out the group, the sort of friends stay in the group, people who are really interested stay with the band, and as you know, we used to back a singer called Johnny Sandon. And he left and ended up with a four-piece.
Well, we heard a lot about the Liverpool sound, or the Mersey sound. I mean, what was the sound like in those days when you first started?
It was very different from most of the bands in Britain. I mean, the variety of bands in Liverpool was very high. You had the likes of ourselves doing country and western at that time. You had the Beatles, you had Jerry and the Pacemakers doing sort of jazz, in fact, sometimes. Swing and Blue Jeans were, in fact, a jazz-type band. Mm. So they're all good bands with different sort of identities.
Now, of course, you came up on the back of the Beatles, if I can say that. The Beatles started things off for Liverpool groups. I mean, how big were they in Liverpool and how did they affect your success?
When the Beatles first started playing in Liverpool, just after they came back from the Star Club Hamburg, I mean, they were something entirely different because they dressed individually in different sorts of black leather gear, sort of boots, and he'd play the Chuck Berry stuff where all the bands are doing all the Cliff Richard stuff and sort of country and western, and the Beatles were playing actually raw rock and roll.
How did you first get your first recording deal? Tell us how it happened.
Well, everybody at that time, like the Jerry, Beatles have had hits, Cilla Black, and all the A&R men were coming from London and looking for bands. In fact, we were one of the last bands to have a hit out of Liverpool. There was a guy named Tony Hatch who got in touch with us, and we made a demo for him and sent it down to him, and he said, "Will you come down and record two of the songs off the demo?" And we did. One of those songs is Sweets from My Sweet. And we went to Germany at that time, playing the Star Club Hamburg, and while we were over there, they released it. Mm. Sweet to My Sweet, it was a slow-selling record at first. It was a sleeper, they called it those days. It was being released for 3 weeks, and then they had an all Liverpool Thank You Lucky Stars, remember it? And they wanted one more band, Liverpool band, to open the show up, and they gave it to us. And we opened it with Sweet to My Sweet, and it was a hit. 2 weeks later, it was number one.
It was said that John Lennon recommended you. Is that correct?
True, yeah. Lennon was the one who recommended Sweets. He said that was the best-sounding record out of Liverpool at the time. He said it doesn't sound like a Liverpool record at all. It sounded very American.
One of the nice things about the Searchers is that you have three members who have been with the band since the 60s. Frank, you joined in the 60s as well, and in fact, are one of the original members, aren't you?
Yeah, it depends how pedantic you want to be. It's sort of like looking at the Shadows and saying, well, Brian Bennett wasn't an original Shadow because Tony Meehan was there for a year beforehand. And it was a bit like me with the Searchers. They'd already been going with Tony since they started. And I'd met them a long time before, though. I met them in 62 at the Star Club Hamburg. I was a member of Cliff Bennett's Rebel Rousers at the time. We used to kind of pal around while we were out there. I got on very well with the band. We kept in touch. And about a year later, they had their first hit. We were still in touch. And about a year after that, when they wanted to make their first change, when Tony was going to have his solo career, they came to me and offered me the job. And I accepted it. It was the best move I ever made. Mm-hmm. So yes, I look on myself as an original member now. Certainly do. It's, you know, the group has been going 30 years now, and I've been with them 28 out of those 30 years. So it's good enough for me.
Billy, you joined the band in the 60s as well. You weren't one of the original members. Tell us how you came to join the Searchers.
I joined in 69, December 69. So I haven't worked that out. Was that 23 years? Mm. Just a friend of mine. The boys were looking for a change of drummer, and a friend of mine recommended me and got together and did the audition. That was it.
What was it like getting to know the Searchers material?
Well, I knew it anyway.
tell them about the rehearsal, Bill. Go on.
What, a rehearsal and a run-through in Frank's lounge?
Yeah, I played a place in Brentford, and the Searchers were on, and I was supporting. And I happened to be playing a few 60s things and et cetera in the band. And John talked to me afterwards, et cetera, and remembered it, puts onto their agent, et cetera, et cetera. And I get a phone call one day.
Said you were rubbish.
Yeah, John said, "Are you rubbish and you're bad enough to play with the Searchers?" No, it just worked from there. You know, he just sort of remembered me and that was it.
welcome the Searchers. Sweet, mama, sweet, shake it for my honey. If that's your kiss, we'll be so. Sweet, mama, sweet, shake it for my honey. I'll never ever let you go. Smiling, I tell the sailor you are blue. I ask you to keep that sailor firing, and to dreams that all come true. Down with sweet, smell of sweet, shake my honey. Give me sweet kiss, real bizarre. Sweet, smell of sweet, shake my honey. I never let you go.
Know what welcome to expect at the City Hall here in Hull. You know, it's great to be back with you. These shows have become not so much a regular part of our routine, but a kind of tradition these days. We almost feel we know every face in the audience. You've been back to see us so many times. And we've got an awful lot of good memories from the shows that we do here, but I have a sneaky feeling that tonight is going to be the best night of all. So are you ready for a party? Because that's what it's going to be. This is going to be a kind of party tonight. And I have to warn you, though, this could be two shows in one, because it's getting hot up here. And if it gets any hotter, this is going to be the Chippendales as well. These clothes will be coming off. We'll try and hold out. Goodness knows we'll try and... What do you mean, no? That kind of audience, is it? Okay, anyway, lose your inhibitions. We'll talk later. Use your voices, use your hands, use whatever you got. But let's celebrate.
Took my troubles down to Malibu. Hey! You know that gypsy with the broken teeth. She's got a pack down the third of the line. Send her in the box of love potion number nine. Told her that I was a flop with cheeks. I've been a swing since 1996. She looked at my phone and she hit on my sound. Say what you need is love potion number nine. She bent down and turned around and gave me a wink. She said, I'm gonna make it up by hearing you sing. You spend a ton of time and look like an evening. I held my nose, I closed my eyes, I took a drink. I didn't know if it was day or night. I started kissing everything in sight. And we were just a cop in the 34th. Oh, my love, love, ocean of a night.
We always know what welcome to expect at the City Hall here in Hull. You know, it's great to be back with you. These shows have become not so much a regular part of our routine, but a kind of tradition these days. We almost feel we know every face in the audience. You've been back to see us so many times. And we've got an awful lot of good memories from the shows that we do here, but I have a sneaky feeling that tonight is going to be the best night of all. So are you ready for a party? Because that's what it's going to be. This is going to be a kind of party tonight. And I have to warn you, though, this could be two shows in one, because it's getting hot up here. And if it gets any hotter, this is going to be the Chippendales as well. These clothes will be coming off. We'll try and hold out. Goodness knows we'll try and... What do you mean, no? That kind of audience, is it? Okay, anyway, lose your inhibitions. We'll talk later. Use your voices, use your hands, use whatever you got. But let's celebrate. There's a whole bunch of some of our lesser known recordings. I'm gonna have to put you down. You've been treating me like a clown. You know you hurt me once before. You never hurt me anymore. Chewy, I'm like a bee, a bumblebee, an evil bumblebee. Sweetest honey, my life, my soul, and all my money. You didn't seem to realize you had all my paradise. Chewy, yeah, I'm like a bee, a bumblebee, an evil bumblebee. That's one of those small hits recorded by our friends, the Hollies. You say that you want me. You got me, you got. But 6 years ago, we had to look for someone new to take over on vocals. And these things are never easy, but I think we found exactly the right person in Spencer James here, didn't we? Glad we have your seal of approval. I didn't doubt it for a minute. Before he joined us, he was actually no stranger to the charts, because he used to be in a band that had an enormous hit. I'm trying to think back to when it was. It was in the summer of 1974. And I don't know if you remember the band at all, but they were called First Class. And the hit they had, it was this one.
Do you remember back in old L.A.? Oh. When everybody drove a Chevrolet? Oh. Whatever happened to the boy next door? Thank you.
volume here. Come on, try it. I think we'll do better if we get away, guys. I knew this was going to be a terrific night when I saw all those Zimmer frames stacked up in the hallway. I thought, these are our people, this is our audience. We'll be putty in our hands. Do you know, the 6 years that Spencer has been with us seems like an awful long time. In fact, the first day seems like a long time, but it's been great, great fun. It's been one of the best times in our lives. But it is a short span in our career, because you probably realise that we are now celebrating, this sounds amazing, our 30th year. Isn't that astonishing? Actually, he's become very affectionately regarded in those 6 years. He's acquired nicknames as well, such as the Teenage Mutant Ninja Gerbil, which I thought was a favourite, and the High-Tech Cabbage Patch Doll, which is also kind of cute, isn't it? But before he joined us, the last person to join was way back on the rear of the stage there. Billy has been on that drum stool now for about just getting on for 24 years, and he's getting incredibly sore. Would you give him some applause? John and I, of course, have been around since Gandhi was a cadet. It doesn't bear thinking about. It's been a long, long time, but happy years. We met in 1962 in Germany, in the red light district of Hamburg, by the way. So, doing nothing like that at all. So we're very, very innocent, as we've remained to this day. I remember seeing you out there as well. No, we were playing at the Star Club, which was one of those momentous places where we kind of learned how to play to crowds and learn a lot of the songs. Great, great times. Learn to drink as well, yeah. The difficulty with shows these days is not what to put into each performance, but what to leave out, because there are people who come to see us time and time again. They would have everything we could ever manage, and we must have recorded about a couple of hundred songs, and time never allows that. But there's one song which we constantly get requests for. It was in the charts in 1965 at number 2, carefully hidden on the B-side of Goodbye My Love, and it's this one. It's called Till I Met You.
Belong to you, but I never knew about love. southern moon was smiling in the dark night sky. But I never knew about love from my head.
Applause is very much appreciated, I promise you. Sounds great from up here. We are going to get the old limbs working in this next one. This serves two purposes, this next song, because it's one of the medium-sized hits, and it also kind of loosens you up so that you're ready for anything. And what we do is wait till you get the signal. Halfway through the verse, I'll give you a signal, and the hands go up in the air. Everybody, straight up in the air, you clap like you've never clapped in your lives. Then I'll tell you when to stop. You get a wee bit of a rest and a breather, because by God, you need it. And then I'll tell you when to start again. Just the same thing in every verse, so that is fairly clear. Do you understand that? Do you understand?
Yeah.
You may understand. Are you going to do it?
Yeah.
This is not going to be a waste of time. You don't sound too sure. I'll trust you. Thousands wouldn't. Here we go.
To try to understand me, you never could do that. I was in the end. You wind up being hurt. I'm a man with many problems to keep up. My sins, the only
Even you can hear keyboard sounds in the backgrounds, and those aren't taped rather than. I'll tell you, they're coming from Spencer's side of the stage because the instrument he's playing is in fact a guitar synthesizer. It doesn't do just the guitar sounds, it does some specialist effects as well, and all that's, I'd say, being played live as well. And we'll prove it to you now because you're probably still sitting there in disbelief. So give them a quick kind of demonstration of a couple of sounds. Impressed? We're going to use one of those special sounds in this next song. I was saying how much we appreciate people buying the new songs. There's one off the Hungry Hearts album that has found an absolute permanent place in our show. And I think, like Needles and Pins, if we didn't do this one in the show, we'd get hung, drawn and quartered before we left the building. And you're so right. I'm not blowing our trumpet there. It's just such a beautiful song with the most incredible words. We tried to get it out as a single once and couldn't convince anyone. I think they were wrong, but you can tell us. It's called Somebody Told Me You Were Crying.
Somebody told me you were gone.
Something a bit special now, a bit different, just one night only. We're at that time of the year which is very, very special and so close to Christmas that we want to start it off right for you and for us indeed. We're getting into the spirit of the things. We want to do a few kind of Christmassy songs here, but don't leave us to do them on our own, promise? Just creep in there, don't be shy about these things, you'll enjoy. Sentiment is nothing to be ashamed of. Here we go.
See. sleigh bells ring, I listen in the lane. Snow is glistening, beautiful sight. We're happy tonight, walking in a winter wonderland. Gone away is the bluebird, here to stay is a new bird. He sings a love song as we go along, walking in a winter wonderland. So here it is, Merry Christmas, everybody's having fun. Look to the future now, it's only just begun. I ain't been out this stocking on the wall. It's the time of year when Santa has a ball. Does he ride?
We've been so lucky, not only in being a part of music that was just about, I think, I don't know if you agree with me or not, I think it was the best decade for pop music, not only in Great Britain, but anywhere in the whole world. It was just so special that, I know, it's wonderful to look back on these days, and I'm sure a lot of you are doing just that, reliving an awful lot of memories. And you're bringing your kids up right as well. You're bringing them up on the 60s decade, which is just a fine thing to see. And during that period, which has been very, very lucky for us, we've had, I think it's about 14 hit songs in the Guinness Book of Hit Singles, and they all mean a lot to us, but we've left the biggest and best to this point. Use your hands, use your voices, use every bit of energy you've got left, because this is Needles and Pins!
Your way, so let me Alex Engelberg.
Shake, baby, shake. Shake, baby, shake. Shake, baby, shake. Shake, baby, shake.
Too ready. Come on. We've had the folkies. Let's have some youth. Come on. Come on. Come here.
Now, as a special surprise, the man who invited the Searchers to play at Wembley. We have him on the phone tonight from his home, Cliff Richard. Hello, Cliff.
Hi there, Chris. I hope you all have a fantastic evening. Me, it's so easy to make a tribute come together for these guys because, as some of you know, I asked the boys to be with me when I was at the Wembley Stadium a couple of years ago. The reason was very simple. I think they're probably the best band from that period. And one of the reasons why I think they're the best band is, first of all, they're still around. Secondly, they never, ever compromised on the kind of songs they did. And what amazed me was that even after all these years, you can still go, walk in the room. And as they all did at Wembley Stadium, everybody knows their stuff, and I think everybody loves them still because they don't compromise their sound or their songs. Good luck, guys, and have a great night.
Cliff Richard, thank you very much. Okay, another surprise. Okay, we have another surprise here. 30 glorious years. What we're going to do now is sing Happy Birthday to the Searchers. Can we have...
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Searchers. Happy birthday to you.
Come on, let's sing it. Hey. Thank you. Thank you very much indeed, lads.
Thank you. It's just been a very, very special night indeed. No one always say this when we come here, but you've got to admit that tonight has topped it, hasn't it? We got a song which embodies the whole spirit of the 60s. That is what we're celebrating. That is what we have tonight. We invite everyone to be a part of this, so use whatever voice you have left. We need your hands, as you will see, and it would be great. You can do it standing up, sitting down, but please do it for us. And if we can join these hands, make sure everyone's hand is joined to everyone else, then it will be the best night we've ever had, and I'm sure it will be. But thanks for everything. Come and see us next year. Keep coming. Thank you.
Through a storm, hold your hand. And don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of a storm, there's a golden sky and a sweet silver song. Our love, walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain. Though your dreams be mistaken, I'm blown. Whoa!
sugar and spice, so don't think that's because it's sweeter than black. Sugar and spice, so don't think that's, you know how the girl is bad. Every man stops and stares at my baby when she's walking down the street. Me and my messy man just look at my baby, it's my baby looks so sweet. Spice, I don't think that's, he says, sweeter than mine. Sugar and spice, I don't think that's, you know that little girl is mine.
One more time.
I saw her today, I saw her face, it was a face I loved. Now I knew I had to be the way, yeah.